with the Ployder device, I will extend the back piece. The new back piece is light and gets this big access for the doctors to check the patient in the emergency room. Okay? Then we're gonna secure the patient. Feel how I control. We control the patient by not manipulating, because one hand controls the head, the other hand makes the adjustments. It's better to make the adjustments on the patient because it's more precise. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're gonna bring this down. Check about clavicles, a little more maybe. There you go, that should be good. Then we follow the steps. We have straps with numbers, and I follow the strap one. Then the two is bilateral, left and right. Left and right. And the three, also left and right. Okay. You see? Mm-hmm. You feel the stabilization going? If you look, you see you rotate your body. Mm. Uh-huh. So, and then feel if the patient gets delivered to the emergency room, the doctor can feel C1, C2, ask the patient any tenderness, so no need to take it off. Mm-hmm. He can feel all the way down, non-stop. It's full access for the doctors or nurses in the emergency room. Okay? Now, if we have, are you okay? Yes? If we have a critical patient and we want, because we have some flexibility here for different shapes on faces, right? So if we want the patient, you find a patient on the scene with that has paralysis or some type of neurodeficit, we want to secure, achieve the highest level of immobilization. And for that, we're going to use an additional strap. This is needed to be done only on the critical patient, so it's a small percentage, right? And we go around. And what we do is just take the slack of the strap. Feel the difference, eh? You feel that?
Mm.
It's even more secure.
Mm.
So if you have that patient with neurodeficit or some type of paralysis, that this is the best for them to move. You're gonna put my fingers.